What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I'm going to show you how I use Pinterest, Make the Dot, the Aesthetics Wiki, and Figma to make mood boards every day that are filled with amazing images, which I then will study in order to develop taste and an eye for art direction and creative direction. Lately, I've been using the Aesthetics Wiki as my starting point when I create a new mood board. I like to come up here to find aesthetics, then by category, and then fashion styles. Let's jump to a random page within the fashion styles and use that for our mood board. The letter G, Gorp Core. I made a mood board about Gorp Core in the past, but I can go deeper on it. And this is a good opportunity for me to actually do this live, so you can see my mood boarding workflow step by step. Before I go into Pinterest, I like to just read a little bit about the aesthetic I'm studying. I learned that GORP stands for good ol' raisins and peanuts, which is a reference to trail mix, which is popular with hikers and those who engage in outdoor exercise, which are the exact types of people that wear GORP Core clothing. The wiki also lists fashion brands that are known for making GORP Core style clothes. This is important and will come into play later. I'm going to make a main mood board for GORP Core, sub mood boards for related aesthetics, and additional sub mood boards for fashion brands. It will make more sense as you watch me build it. After I've read about the aesthetic, I'll create a new board within my workspace and make the dot. I'll leave a link to make the dot in the description. So here's my new board. I'm going to name this Gorp Core. And then I'm going to make sure that the Make the Dot Chrome plugin is enabled. I'm going to click this. Now it's enabled. And now I can go into Pinterest, highlight any photo, press the Make the Dot button, and then save it to this board. Let's start by looking up the keyword Gorp Core. In the suggestions, there are several subcategories of Gorp Core that we can look up. But for now, I'm just going to start with the main keyword. Next step will be just to scan these images, just catch a vibe. I'm not looking for anything specific right now. I'm just looking for anything that makes me feel something. As I'm going, if I see something that inspires me, I'll press the save to make the dot button. Then this right panel pops up, where you can see all the images I save. However, I'm not gonna save every tile I see in this Pinterest board. I wanna be more strategic than that. I'm gonna fold this for now, but as you can see here on the right side, the plugin is still active. I think this is cool. Gorp Core mixing with street fashion in an urban setting. Love this shot. I'm a big fan of outdoor winter sports. Let's click on that. Now Pinterest algorithm is going to suggest a ton of photos that are similar. This one's cool. Love skiing. Save that one. Seeing a lot of stealth style, glasses on, face covered photos. Let's check that out. Seeing a lot of Arc'teryx, which was mentioned as the first brand here related to Gorp Core in the Aesthetics Wiki. I noticed I have quite a few of those photos saved here. Let's add a couple more. I think they're cool. All right, now let's go deeper into skiing because I dig that. But now I feel like this is not really Gorp Core anymore. This is kind of like its own winter skiing aesthetic. So maybe let's actually go back. That's a good example of realizing when you've gone too far into a different aesthetic on Pinterest. You don't really want to be saving everything. You want to be tactical or strategic about it. As you develop your eye, you'll be able to distill the differences between these photos and the aesthetics and the sub-aesthetics to create refined mood boards. All right, let's keep going back. Okay, so now we're on the main Gorp Core tile page. This is cool. Let's save that. Now we have more content from this content creator. She's fire, but that's not Gorp Core. This is not Gorp Core. Okay, now we're starting to stray away from the aesthetic again. Let's click on this one and see where this takes us. I dig the outside shots. These are fire. This looks like a vintage Nike ad. This Arc'teryx ad goes super hard. We'll save that. Now we have 17 images here. It's getting there. I like this. Again, with this street style mixed with Gorp Core aesthetic in an urban setting. Let's go deeper into this. I dig this. This is cool. I really like this fit. I really like this fit. This isn't so much Gorp Core, but it's adjacent, so I'm gonna add it. It made me feel something. I dig it. Let's add these into our Make the Dot board. Pick the board that I made earlier and press save. Here are all the images. Everything winter related, I'm going to put over here. Anything outdoors and in nature, I'm going to put over here. Anything in an urban or city setting, I'm going to put over here. I have two photos left over that look like they were shot indoors. I bet I can find some more photos like that. So now I'm back on Pinterest and I'm looking for Gorp Core aesthetic shot indoors. Okay, let's click on this. All right, now we're getting somewhere. Now we have some e-commerce and fashion photography. Let's add this one and this one. Let's go further down this rabbit hole. This out like that. Let's add that. Some garment photography, more on model in an urban setting, more fashion e-commerce. Let's add those to the board. Let's put all these photos together over here. This was outdoors. We'll put that with the other outdoor photos. But this kind of looks like e-commerce photography. that could go up on a website, or even editorial photography that could be used as a print ad or something, which is definitely different than these iPhone style photos. So I'll kind of put it here like in the middle. Here's a similar photo. It's kind of like that e-commerce on model vibe, but in an urban setting. So let's put all of these over here and then bridge the gap this way. So now it kind of flows from e-commerce to outdoor. Here's more of an urban setting. And again, editorial content, like an old print ad. Okay, here is a quick Gorp Core mood board that I just made using Pinterest and Make the Dot. Let's add some photos from these fashion brands. So come back here to Pinterest and put in Arc'teryx. We can see all of the brand's Pinterest boards here, which is just a gold mine of Gorp Core content. I'll add these to the mood board as well. Let's save that one. These are giving me ideas for lifestyle content that I could shoot outside for my own brand. Now let's look up Arc'teryx outfit. Save these ones, save this one, and I'll save this one. Now we'll add those to the Gorp Core board. As you can see, all the photos related to the Arc'teryx keywords fit with our current board. Here's how it looks after I rearranged the photos. Okay, now what do we have on the list? Salomon is the next brand. Let's look up Salomon. These shoes, this is a cool photo. More shoes. Skis, let's add those to the board. Put these in their own section. Shoes live in their own world. Back to the aesthetics wiki, Patagonia. I like this one. More flat life photography, which I don't have enough of in the board. We'll add these to the Gorp Core board. I'll rearrange these. Okay, everything's starting to look pretty good. Let's now look at Oakley. Some cool Oakley photos here. Let's get a little more specific though. Oakley Gorp Core. That one's really cool. These are really cool. Oakley's with Arc'teryx. Let's check this out. Getting more into snowboarding and sports aesthetic, which is obviously adjacent to Gorp Core. This one's sick. This is sick. This is already in the board. I love these. This is awesome. I've never seen this before. I'll save that for later. Now I'm getting more into the algorithm of like avant-garde Gorp Core. That's much more expensive than Patagonia. Let's save these to the board. Then I'll arrange these here. Looking pretty good. This is the mood board I made, which I can study. I can discuss these images with ChatGPT or Claude. But before that, I think it's really important to first go back to the aesthetics wiki, then look at these related aesthetics and make mood boards for these as well. First, we have Cabin Core. I'm going to speed run this. This one, this one, this one, this, 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 this one, this one. Okay, so I have 16 photos here. I'm going to save them to a new board that we'll call Cabin Core. I'm going to go back to Make the Dot, go to Cabin Core, rearrange these a little. Now we have a mood board for Cabin Core. What's next? Let's pick Nature Core. We'll type Nature Core into Pinterest. I have 12 more images here. I'll create a board, call this Nature Core. So far we made Gorp Core, Cabin Core, and Nature Core. I'll rearrange these a little bit really quick. Now I've made mood boards for one main aesthetic and two sub aesthetics. I'm going to take screenshots of those boards and then put them into one Figma board. Here's Nature Core. I'll drag that into Figma. Here's Cabin Core. And then my main Gorp Core board. I'll drag that into Figma and then I'll resize. I've named this FigJam board Gorp Core and I put it in my Creative Director folder. And from here, I can break down each photo, analyze differences between Gorp Core and its sub aesthetics. I can also drag the images into ChatGPT or Claude and discuss them with an AI. So to recap, we picked an aesthetic from the aesthetics wiki. We made a mood board for that aesthetic. We made two mood boards for sub aesthetics related to that main aesthetic and included photos related to three specific fashion brands that are tied to the culture of that aesthetic. We used Pinterest and Make the Dot to easily add images to our mood boards with just a couple clicks. And we took one more step in developing our eye for aesthetics, creative direction, and art direction. So that's it for this video. If you found this valuable or you learned something new, please like and subscribe. It helps me out so much. If there's a topic that you'd like me to cover in the future, please leave a comment and I'll see you in the next video.